Hi, I'm Tommy Mester from data36.com, and in this short video, I will answer a question that frequently comes up in my online courses, which is how to upload a data file like your own CSV or TXT or TSV raw data files to a remote server. It's a simple question, and the answer is pretty simple as well, but I get this from time to time, so I assume that this is a common problem for people who just got started learning data science. So I figured I will just quickly record a video where I will show the solution, and instead of sending this to my course participants only, I will just publish it on YouTube so others, like you, can take advantage of it too. Anyways, let's see how it's done. So, the issue is simple. You have your local computer where you have a data file, let's say this example.csv in your documents folder, and you want to upload this to your remote data server, and I will show you two solutions for this problem. In the first one, I will use the command line, which I call the painful solution for this one, and in the second one, I will use Jupyter, which is a web application which I mainly use to prototype my Python code, but it will be very handy for this file upload issue as well. Now, if you don't know what a remote data server is, or you don't know what Jupyter is, just check out the remote server setup tutorial that I linked in the description. In that article, I show you how you can install Python and SQL step by step to learn and practice data science in a real-life-like environment. So check that out and install your server and Jupyter. But if you have these already, because let's say you are a course participant and we set this up in the first lecture, right? Then just follow me. Let's see the painful solution first. Here I will show you a solution that works on Mac and Linux only. You can do similar things on Windows using PuTTY. But generally speaking, you don't have to worry about it because I show this to you only to demonstrate how painful it is, so you can better appreciate the second solution that will work on all operating systems anyway. Okay, the first solution. Open a terminal window, and right now you are on your local computer. Go to the folder where you store your data file locally. So for me, it's cd:\example. And here I have example.csv and example2.csv. The next step is typing the actual copy command, which will start like scp, which stands for Secure Copy Protocol. Then you type your file name, preferably with the full path included. So for me, it's users\tommy-master\desktop\example\example.csv. But if you are in this folder already, and I am, it's fine to add simply example.csv, right? Anyways, I generally prefer to use full path names, so I will do that. users\tommy-master\desktop\example\example.csv. So far, we have the copy command and the file we want to copy. The next step is to specify where we want to copy it to. So the next step is to type the details of your remote server, more specifically the username and the IP address, just as if you were SSHing to your server. For me, it will be tommy@myservers.ip address, 134.122.73.132, and then colon and this tilde character that will specify that this goes directly into your users folder on your remote server, and then you can specify the folder you want to copy this into, given that it exists on the server. So for me, it will be the upload_demo folder that I created before, and we have everything we need: the copy command, the file we want to copy, and the destination on our remote server. Hit enter, type your password. And the file is uploaded. If you SSH to your server, so for me, SSH Tommy at 1341327 7 3 1 3 2, and I go to the right folder, CD upload demo, you will see that the file is there as it should be. Well, this was a small demo file, but you can upload bigger files, of course, using the scp command. But from this point on, I could use this example.csv file for my projects that are done on my data server. And this is how you upload a data file to your data server via the command line, at least on Mac and Linux. But this can be done using PuTTY on Windows as well. But generally speaking, I find this process a bit painful, at least compared to the second solution that works on all operating systems anyway. For the second solution though, you will need Jupyter installed to your remote server already. Again, I assume that you have this, as most people learning data science and Python like to work in Jupyter. But if you don't, check out the server setup tutorial in the description. Okay, if you have Jupyter on your remote server, then the first step again is to log into your server. As I'm on Mac, I will do this in terminal. If you are on Windows, use PuTTY. Well, actually, I'm already logged in. So I will just go back to my main folder. And once you are logged in, you can start Jupyter using the Jupyter notebook -- browser any command. Cool. And once it's running, I will go to the browser window, type in my server's IP address, like this, and colon 888. Just as we do all the time when running Jupyter notebook, I will copy paste my token because I don't have a password yet. You might have one already. And the good thing is that in Jupyter, you can pretty much upload your file point and click, because in this top right corner, there is an upload button. How convenient that is, right? So just go to your folder, upload demo. Here is the file that I uploaded via the command line already, and upload the second file by clicking upload. Select example2.csv, click upload again, and there it is. Very, very simple, as I promised. Let me open this file. There it is. And there is the example.csv file as well. Very, very simple, just as I promised. Okay, that's it. This is the simplest way to upload a data file to a remote server. Well, at least if you are a data scientist using Jupyter on your remote server. If not, you can still take advantage of the first method and use SCP. But again, to be honest, I don't really use that method anymore, because the Jupyter one is just more convenient. But with that being said, this is the end of this short video. If you liked it, please subscribe, leave a rating or a comment, and remember, the best way to get notified about new videos is always the DATASET newsletter list, the only place where I really communicate to my audience right now. You can subscribe to it at datasert6.com/newsletter. And hey, if you do so, you will get access to a lot of free learning materials too, including my free mini course called How to Become a Data Scientist. Thank you for listening. I'm Tommy Mester from datasert6.com. Until next time.